Some viewers may find this disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
What's good, everybody? It's Destin Choice, you're watching Choice TV. So a lot of y'all kept asking me to talk about this whole Chris and Kareem situation. And my immediate reaction when I heard was, I told y'all hoes. Because literally, every time I would call them out on being in a fake relationship and them being scammers, like, I would get so much fucking hate and nobody would believe me. But like, now there's like picture proof. Now there's like solid evidence, pow, in your face proof. So literally, if you notice that my voice is just all lost and shit, please ignore that. I'm sick as fuck. And a lot of y'all who are wondering why I've been gone for so long, basically, for those of y'all who've been wondering why I've been gone for like 6 days, basically, Hurricane Irma came through and fucked Florida the fuck up with this damn electricity. There was no damn power, and I couldn't even figure out a way to film. So the power is finally back on, and now I'm ready to fucking film. And I also want to say thank you guys for everything. Thank you guys for 49K. You guys are amazing. You guys are the realest. I'll never change, no matter how many followers or how much money I fucking get. Like, no. Like, materialistic things and items won't change me. Fuck that. I'm not Chandler Alexis. So this video is about Chris and Kareem. So for those of y'all who are like way behind on this drama, I'm not even gonna waste my time like summing this shit up in 5 minutes. Long story short, Chris got involved with some thought tot and she literally exposed the shit out of him. So basically this is what happened. Chris had left his son and his wife back at home, and he left and went to Cali and traveled and basically had fun and did business at the same time. Now, little that we all knew, he was doing more than just business. So this girl recently uploaded a video talking about how Chris and her fucked.
Gave me a hug and he's flirting with me and grabbing all over me, and he was just like, which one of you is a freak? And I was like, what? And then he's like, which one of you is a freak? And I was like, what the hell? Like, what the hell is wrong with you? Like, how are you gonna flirt with the both of us?
He started talking to us about his YouTube channel. We had a really good conversation. Mind you, we have no idea who Kareem is.
Yeah.
He never watched this YouTube. He's just basically talking about how he has a baby mama and they're like good friends and they started YouTube together. So he's in it for like the money. He talked to us about how they fake their pranks. And now that he's not here, we have got the perception that he lied, and she seems to think that they are happily married.
Yeah.
We were never told he was married. He was single.
He does have a ring on his finger.
No ring. He just made us think he did some YouTube with his baby mama, but they only did it for money, and they have this child together, and that was really all we got from the conversation with him.
Something that would happen to a girl that's just like drunk in a hotel, like you could put the pieces together, but it's really hard for me to talk about this because I actually really liked him. I fell for him. I fell for everything that he told me.
Okay.
Fucking bitch.
So what you thought was gonna happen? You thought y'all was gonna play dominoes and sit on the couch and watch SpongeBob? No, you're gonna get fucked. That is disgusting. I don't see how people could do that. Do not fuck random people. That is just trifling as hell. Especially if they're trying to get at your friend. That's just trifling, bitch. Why? Like, just don't do it. Like, just don't have sex with random people. It's disgusting. Motherfuckers is dirty out here, and that makes me want to just fucking die a virgin. Like, See, I don't respect these type of hoes because in this video she kind of said, well, I mean, I was kind of drunk and, I mean, put the pieces together, you know. Somebody who's drunk, you know, alone, you know, what do you think? So it's like, whoa, girl, okay, choose your words wisely because you're making it seem like or sound like this dude took advantage of you when really you just opened your boom boom to him. Like, no, don't do that shit. So, I don't respect hoes like this. Like, I respect hoes. Like, smart hoes don't get cold. And this girl literally just made a fool of herself. Like, I respect her a little bit, just this much, for doing this video because she literally proved all of us who had an assumption or had a conspiracy that Chris was cheating. Chris was a fraud. Chris and Kareem are frauds. She explained in this video that Chris and her had a thing going on. And I'm like, why in the hell would Chris cheat on Kareem with Rufus from Kim Possible. Why the hell is Chris cheating on Queen with these teenage boys? Like, I'm very confused. Like, what the fuck is going on? So I watched the video more in depth, and literally she explains how Chris admitted to her how they do fake pranks and how they're doing this for money. And then she talks about in the video how, oh, you know, Chris, I feel like he played me and I feel like he lied. And she literally shows receipts. She literally showed receipts after receipts after receipts proving that they were together and they had Snapchats together. She claims she didn't know much about Chris, but it's like, if you didn't know much about Chris, why the hell was your dumbass Snapchatting him Well, what is that, bitch? What is that? You was literally Snapchatting him the whole time, so obviously you wanted bragging rights. You put him all over your Snapchat, and then what happens next? You invite him to your hotel, you guys Uber, and she wants to talk about somehow I fell for him and he... Bitch, fell for what? Fell for what? Fell for his crunchy, crusty dick? Bitch, what you mean you fell for him? You make no sense. You make absolutely no fucking sense. She literally is going in talking about somehow she needs to expose Chris and let everybody know about them. And I can understand that she wants to expose them and let everybody know that they're not what they say they are. I respect that. But don't try to make it seem like you're not a hoe when you kind of are. They later uploaded a video talking about responding to the hate, basically reading all the damn hate comments they was getting. Because good sweet Jesus Lord, the hate comments they were getting was crazy. Yeah, that was sweet Jesus. Ooh, they came for this girl's life. Like, Chris and Queen's fandom is strong. Like, I thought people was coming for me. Like, just the other day, this bitch commented, oh my God, you're so jealous of Chris and Queen's bond. You're just jealous because you can't get a woman like Queen or a beautiful man like Chris. And I'm like, oh my God, like, bitch, what the fuck did I do? So think about it like this. This whole situation is happening, and I don't understand why Chris... I don't care. This girl is trifling as fuck. She's a hoe. Like, I don't care if anyone's mad at me for that. Chris is a hoe too. Chris is a hoe. This bitch is a hoe. Her friend is a hoe. They all hoes. They all scammers. I don't care what nobody say. Like, real shit. Like, real shit. That's just some hoe shit. She talks about how she just wanted to do this, you know, to expose him. But it's like, girl, you're doing this obviously for a come up, which is okay, because hoes try to come up off of people's names all the time by, you know, saying they fucked them or whatever. And I really hope Chris fucked these bitches with a condom, because oh my God, that is disgusting, that is trifling. How do you have sex with random people? Like, if you're gonna be, you know, promiscuous and wild and young and live your life, that's fine. But having sex with a random person, oh, random. And then this bitch only knew her for 2 days. And she's talking about something. I really fell for him. Fell for what? Bitch, stop lying. I can smell the lies, bitch. I'm Caribbean. Caribbean people can tell when children are fucking lying. Like, she just made no sense at all. So, as I go further and more in depth into the video, I start to sense a little bit of bullshit. I see that Chris later uploaded a video titled, "Did I Cheat on Queen?" And that video was uploaded 13 hours after that video, they posted their video. So I'm like, whoa, 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 whoa. Their video says 13 hours ago, and when I saw Chris's video, it had said like 30 minutes ago or something like that. And I'm like, of all things to admit to, why the fuck is Chris gonna admit to cheating on Queen? He's literally risking it all and losing everything. Like, this whole drama is just absolutely crazy to the point where these bitches is getting involved.
I'm about to go to Dallas.
For what? They proved it, bro.
So it's like, okay, yeah, these bitches of course want a piece of that, you know, ad money. So this drama has gotten like way out of control. And if you ask me, like, this just don't make no sense. And then in this, it's like, things just aren't adding up. Like, you didn't know anything about Queen, yet you were so ready to Snapchat Chris when he told you he did YouTube. You were so ready to move your crusty ass thumbs to that Snapchat button, But you didn't want to go on YouTube and Google this dude. You didn't at least Google the dude that you was fucking. She said all she knew was that Chris did YouTube and he had all these followers and he was gonna help her do YouTube. And then, boom, he fucked you and now you mad, bitch. Now you wanna do a come up video. So that's what really rubbed me the wrong way. And then in their video that they, by the way, deleted, which she later made a video that she deleted after 5 hours called Responding to the Hate.
LMAO, you really wanna get your name up, don't you?
My name is already up. It's falling down.
Her name has been up though.
My name, like, the reason why this video is actually getting so many comments and so many, like, people seeing it is because, like, my name is already up there. Do you know who I am? I'm Jada motherfucking Amor.
She wrong for messing with a married man. She didn't know though. I think you guys are forgetting the point. Part that she doesn't know.
The thing is, also, a lot of these hate comments is saying that you guys should know who they are, and we don't.
Our friends don't even know. Like, I'm trying to tell them, explain them what's going on. They have no idea who I'm talking about. They have to go search this couple online. Like, and, like, they aren't that big thing. In LA. Like,
so empty of this information.
He filled us in, and he told us it's just a baby mama, and that he's planning on doing his own thing.
Yep. And so, he was trying to set us up YouTube.
Yeah.
So we were already planning on making YouTube.
YouTube. He said he would manage us. Like, there's so much. Y'all don't even know.
It was all fake, though. Him saying that he was gonna manage us and all this stuff was just to get Helena to sleep with him.
Oh.
To make her feel like he really genuinely cared. He should not even be giving her liquor. So the fact that she is underage, he's giving her liquor, it's because he's trying to pursue something with her and trying to get
on
her
on a dinner date. So
and trying to,
that's the thing, these people just don't even know.
And you guys, what we're doing is for girls that have been in positions like this. We're speaking on it, we're acting on it, and we have our friends back.
And this girl is literally like, I'm Amor Jada. I don't need to search for clout. It's like, bitch, I never heard of you. The only Amor Jada I know is the bitch on Instagram that sell counterfeit bundles. So her name is actually Jada Amor, not Amor Jada. And I look into this girl, and she already has a following. The girl, Helena Hakaka, whatever the fuck her name is, she has a following of at least 13,000 people. The other one, who looks like this girl right here, she looking like she dressed for a damn quinceañera.
Which is really...
But here's my theory. What if all this is fake? Because I noticed that when people doing their reaction videos, when people did their reviews on this situation, I noticed, yeah, nobody questioned if this was fake or not. I mean, she had receipts. She had receipts out the ass. She was so ready to expose him. And then when she FaceTimed him, I fucking screamed. Like, thumbs up if you screamed. Like, I screamed. When she FaceTimed him, I was like, yo. But then again, Chris being a public figure, why are you just now admitting to all the wrong you're doing? Why did you admit to cheating on Queen? Why didn't you admit to cheating on Queen with the transsexual? Or why didn't you admit to your dick pic getting leaked all over social media, which I'm still scarred to this day by? Why didn't you own up to the whole iPhone situation? So when I see this situation, I think, damn, I smell fat, bad, computer-shaped ass bitch.
Says Damien didn't want to try and hear. I guess the daddy said you're gonna hear me now.
This not making no sense to me. Like, what if this is all fake? Think about it. This is my theory. What if this was all just a publicity stunt just to start something? Why is Chris, like, Chris, the video was only at 6,000 views when Chris made his video explaining that he cheated on Queen. So obviously, him talking about how he cheated on Queen, people gonna wanna do some research and find out who he cheated on Queen with. So that obviously gives this video more publicity. And oh my God, I don't care what nobody said. Them bitches were ratchet as fuck. They were so fucking ratchet. Oh my God. Like, the girl in the middle.
Sad. And I know that's why you guys are here.
Like, I'm telling y'all, the manager probably did her damn makeup. Like, her highlight, it wasn't even highlight. It was sweat. Like, no. Like, it's a no. And then the bitch right here with the damn red top.
And that she's just like, whatever, but like.
I don't care what nobody says. I'm pretty sure the manager let her that damn wig. The manager let her the wig. And then this girl right here, she's dressed like she's going to a damn quinceañera. Her edges damn near about to evaporate or some shit.
I'm Jada.
And then it's like, if this is all real, why would Chris cheat on Queen with Ratchet 3 Blind Mice? Like, come on now. These are hoes. These hoes are looking for a come up if this is real. But my theory is, think about it like this. Y'all remember when D&B Nation was at 1.8 million followers, when D&B Nation was at 1.9 million followers, and then in a week, they hit 2 million because of all the drama they did, and then they ended up getting so much hate? If you put the pieces together, what if the manager set all this up? This is the same thing that happened to D&B Nation. When D&B Nation were at 1.8, 1.9 million, they were doing all these publicity stunts to get to 2 million even quicker. Think about, like, why is Chris exploiting their business on social media? I mean, the video didn't even get that many views, and he just, I don't know, exploited it. And if you look closely at the FaceTime, Chris is wearing the same shit in his apology video.
Yeah.
It took a lot for me to, you know, come on here and announce this to the public, but...
as he is in the FaceTime, that same dirty ass red and black jersey. So it's either they playing us, or it's either Chris dirty as fuck. Shit, probably both. So this all, in a way, it's interesting, and it really blows us all away. But what if this is all a stunt? Like, what if this is a D&B Nation 2.0 stunt? Like, why is he cheating on Queen with my Lucha Vejo 2.0? The fuck? These bitches damn like they fucking 12 wearing makeup and shit. Like, their makeup was trash. Her makeup was terrible. Bruh. Like, no. Like, girl, are you in the sixth grade trying makeup for the first time? That shit was a mess. I don't know what that was. Just like D&B, just like Damian did, he publicly spoke out about his personal issues with Bianca. Chris is doing the same thing with Queen. Putting out his personal business on the internet. It's just they're doing it better than D&B Nation. They got everybody fooled. Like, it's to the point where the hate is so terrible, to the point where they're even going on Baby CJ's page. So this kind of rubs me the wrong way a little bit, because what if this manager lady really is involved? What if she's put, like, I'm, to be honest, this is all I gotta say. Chris and Queen, they damn near just got their BSN at D&B University. Like, I'm pretty sure they just finished studying at D&B Nation University. Okay, this whole situation, I smell some D&B Nationness. Like, I smell D&B Nationness. I don't care. Like, I've been saying this. They D&B Nation Junior. They don't make no sense. Like, this situation, it looks like it could be real. But like I always say, I would never put anything past Chris and Queen. We been knew Chris was cheating. Why the fuck is you just not coming for it, bitch? And then she later said in her video, her responding to the hate comments video, which she deleted after a few hours, she said Chris threatened her and said, I know where you live, I'm gonna harm you, blase, blase. And it's like, damn.
Already called and threatened us and said, I know where you live, you guys better delete it before Queen sees that. Like, and we have it on video. So we're gonna stay tuned for our next video. We're gonna put that footage in there.
Yep.
We got it when he called us and threatened us, so. He's seen it. Queen, I don't think she's seen it yet. We're not sure. Hasn't heard from her, but he's already threatening us and saying stuff. So
he posted
another video. We're gonna wait.
This is my theory. This is some D&B Nation computer shaped that fat back computer shaped ass bitch type shit. Like, this just don't make no sense. She says she fell for a guy she only known for 2 days. Bitch, are you serious? Girl, are you in middle school? Like, are you sure you're grown? Because you wanna, like, how old are you? Chris and Queen will do anything for views. They've proven that. And you might be saying, why would they risk their fan base? Why would they risk their audience? Why would they risk their credibility, their loyal fan base for all of this? Well, the truth is, money is a hell of a drug. Money will make people do anything. And ask yourself the same question. Why would DMV Nation do all that? Why did DMV Nation do all that? For shmoney. They want shmoney. And this manager bitch is doing the same thing. This manager bitch, I'm telling you, she did this bitch makeup. I'm telling you, this manager did this girl makeup. Because that shit is a travesty. And I'm telling you, she let her wig to that girl with the red top. Because what the... That wig! Oh my god! Like, the top is like fucking... It's like, I've been you, Chris and Queen. We're on some phony shit, on some lying shit. But why are they all of a sudden coming forth and being real? Think about it. Why are they real all of a sudden? Why couldn't y'all talk about the iPhone situation? Y'all lied about the iPhone situation. Y'all literally lied, as far as I assume, about the whole miscarriage thing and came about it the whole wrong way. Y'all committed a crime on camera. So why should I believe that this is a stunt for views? Why do I feel like they're gonna eventually come back and say, guys, it was a prank. What's good, CQ Mafia? It was a prank. And the minute they do that, they're going to lose about 80,000 subs in 24 hours. Trapped in a changing maze, setting my soul ablaze. Couldn't control the pace.
Words is going, hey. Heartless is reckless, it's this word of a pacifist. Who is ready to, you know what I'm saying, just do all this stuff for him. So if your man asks you, babe, can you suck my dick? Damn right I'ma suck your dick, cause if I don't do another bitch will, why would I want another bitch sucking your dick? Cause all the pictures we take together, all this, bruh, I'm just gonna let y'all know, this nigga dick is like 10 inches, no lie, thick as fuck, oh my god, I swear to god, that's my baby.
Posted his damn video talking about it, giving his response. His ashy ass video was boring as fuck. Like, this dude was just rambling on about God, like, oh no, like, yo. Like, Chris's voice is so annoying. It's so damn cringy. Like, his voice is like nails on a fucking chalkboard because he's always fucking talking about bullshit. Like, bitch, what? Like, you make no sense at all. Like, Chris, just, like, he's just talking, and he talks about how, you know, she was my sweetheart, like, his hot ass breath, like, I could feel the fogginess of his breath, he then blabs on and blabs on about how, you know, we can't just throw away 5 years. You cheat on this bitch with a transgender? You cheat on this bitch with three little thot tots? Three malucha vejos? And your immediate response is, well, we can't throw away 5 years. Get the fuck out of here. Chris and Queen are frauds. They make no sense. And all this stuff, it could be real. But that's exactly what I said about DMV Nation. It could be real. This is all a messy situation. Leave your thoughts down below in the comment section. Please let me know what y'all think. This all is just a mess. It just doesn't make any sense when I put the pieces together. Because this is something DMV Nation did. Think about it. This is the same thing DMV Nation did. When they were borderline 2 million subscribers, they did publicity stunts. They lie. They try to exploit their business on social media for attention, for views. Now, think about it like this. Chris and Queen haven't uploaded a video in like 2 days, 3 days so far since the apology video. So the next video is going to be some clickbait bullshit like, are we back together, or the truth, or the sit-down conclusion, just like DMV Nation. So this fat back computer shaped ass bitch manager, she has been getting heavily involved, and I can tell, Chris and Queen, if y'all see this, I suggest y'all stomp while y'all are ahead. Like, y'all might as well just quit and just keep posting them fake ass, corny ass pranks with dreadful laughs and Arm & Hammer and cafeteria tray. Like, please, like, just keep posting these corny ass pranks, because that's what's gonna help your channel still grow, even though people will we'll fucking hate y'all, but just stop with all that and just continue doing this whole fake playing bandwagon bullshit. Because if y'all come back and try to start this drama shit, it's gonna have everybody like, damn, bitch, like, did you just get your BSN at DMB University? Because this just not making no sense. It makes sense, but then you gotta think about it like this. This is like a duplicate of what DMB Nation did. But that was that for this video. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Give your comments down below. Tell me what y'all thought about this video. And yeah, I love you all so much. Thank you so much for the support. Almost at 50K. And yeah, enjoy the music. Choice out this bitch.
Kaya is the both of them. It's like he's Kaya's little angel looking over him. And I know Jelani will always love me and I'll always love him. And I'm just his little sister, not Nicki Minaj when I'm around him. Gee, we did it. Let's leave this imprint. Just finish writing. This is the pink print.